Tracy, those guys made a run at you guys, got it back tied up 46 there late, and then you guys made pretty much all the stops down the stretch and got this one pulled out. How important was that after they had made that run and considering what had happened at Wisconsin that you guys closed this one out the right way?
I think it just shows that we're growing as a team. It was really big for us. I think our defense is really what kept us in the game. And I think our defense is going to be a really big part of what keeps us in a lot of games. So that's what we hold our hat on. And we made plays down the stretch. We got stops down the stretch that we needed to, and then we pulled that one out. So I thought it was good for us.
You've asked about Parker in a couple different ways. Parker, sorry, I kind of mumbled through that. Forgive me. But whether it's maybe the extra semester he had, I know obviously there's a coaching change, but he was with you guys even before that, or maybe it's something else, but just what has allowed him to fit so seamlessly kind of into the flow of the offense to the degree that I think he's shooting at or near 50% from three, and it's at volume too. It's you know, he's not shooting like 5 of 10 or 10 of 20, no. Something like that.
Parker's just he's one of the most gracious guys on our team. He's so we all love him, and we know when he's out on the floor, we know exactly where he is at all times. So we try to find him, and for some reason, teams keep leaving him, and we're gonna feed him shots, and he's gonna hit those shots. So you've seen it. So and we're gonna keep feeding him.
I got one for each of you. For Race, Mike Bray was talking about Trace's impact, just presence at the rim defensively. You go against him in practice. How much does he impact is your ability to score at the rim?
Mine, personally, he doesn't affect me.
For anybody who's trying to score against him at the rim.
Oh, he definitely changes people's shots. You go up for a layup, if he's coming over, you got to adjust because he's going to block it if you don't. So, I mean, he does it in practice, he does it in the games. And honestly, if I get beat, I'm like, dang, well, Trace is going to block it anyway, so... I'm not too worried about it. But, yeah, he's definitely a rim protector.
And then for Trace, wanted to get your thoughts on the lift Finnessy he gave you tonight. Gives you 2 threes, team-high 5 assists, helps hold Blake Wesley to 5 for 16. Your thoughts on Rob's play tonight?
The thing is, Rob hasn't been 100% yet. He hasn't been 100% all year. And I think when he gets there, he's going to be really, really big for us, a big addition to our team. But he's trying to grind it out. He's trying to practice. But he just got to get healthy. And I think he's starting to get healthier, and he's starting to get his confidence. And once Rob has his confidence, he can do a lot of good things for us.
For either guy, I'm curious if the improved three-point shooting, kind of more threats on the floor, is making it a little easier for you guys inside, or how is that affecting maybe the floor spacing a little bit?
Definitely makes it easier for us both. It's hard for the other teams to dig on me and Trace, because if they do, me and Trace are completely comfortable and unselfish enough to throw the ball out and have confidence in our teammates to shoot the ball. Even tonight when they're going under on X, and sure, he shot like 2 for 9 from three-point, but again, I would tell him to shoot the 10th one because he can make that shot. But, I mean, definitely, I mean, just having that outside threat makes it easier for us to do what we want to do. And then, again, if we get too hard digged on, we'll kick it out and they'll knock it down.
Trace, you're the focal point every night of every team. How do you get yourself physically, mentally ready for all the various defenses, doubles, non-doubles? How do you get yourself ready to play at a high level?
You just got to take what the defense gives you, really. I think today I was a little sped up with the double team, missed a few easy ones, obviously. But at the same time, you can't get too high or too low because they're going to keep – Coach Woodson's going to have emphasis on keep feeding me. So, and then my teammates are the same way. They know I'm the best player on the team and I got to play like it. So even down the stretch when I miss a few shots, miss a few things, they're still trying to compliment me and raise me up to be – just go out next play. So basically that.
Back on the topic of Rob, you guys talked about how he's not 100% yet and making sure that Coach talked about giving him that confidence that he needs. How do you guys give him that confidence on the floor?
I think all of us as a team, we know what each one of us are capable of, and we know what we can do. We've seen it on the floor. I mean, I played with Rob for 3 years now. I know he's had his games where he's been unbelievable. So we know every player on our team and what we can do, and we just got to just keep telling him, even if you miss a shot, shoot the next one. I think X was the same way today. X missed a few shots. He's wide open. They're playing him at the free throw line. We just got to keep shooting it. I mean, I've seen him hit 2 or 3 shots in a row, so it's just basically just confidence, and we just got to keep telling each other. I mean, you can hit those shots. You can do anything that you need to do, basically.
Race, you obviously ended up on the perimeter on a lot of switches today. You're just defending those guards. That's something, obviously, you've gotten used to this season. How do you think you've gotten better at that? How have you become a better defender when you find yourself in a switch against a 2 or a 3?
I mean, I try to keep my little bit of space. Sometimes they got to step on me a little quicker than me, maybe. But I try to just be smart about it. Think about, like, I really pay attention to personnel when we do that, what they want to do, what this player likes to do. And I don't know, I just really key in on that and know that player's strength and try to force him away from that. And again, force him to trace if I get beat or to the middle or to where most of the help is. So, I mean, it's really just a scouting thing. And just overall, just keep doing it and keep getting more comfortable with it. I think it's good for me.
Guys, in the first 12 minutes of the game, I think you guys combined for only 3 attempts from the field. What changes were made to get you more looks?
I think Coach Woodson, big emphasis. whenever that happens, he has big emphasis right from the start. He starts yelling and starts getting in people's faces, talking about playing inside out. So I think that was a big thing, big key. But at the same time, we trust our guards to make the right plays, and if they want to shoot the ball, they can shoot the ball. I know they can hit shots. So, but after that first sequence, he came and he said, we're playing inside out the rest of the game. So,
Trace, Notre Dame coach Mike Bray talked about your demeanor, being able to play at the high level that you play at, but always do that at a calm demeanor, like today when there was a potential flagrant foul issue, but it all stayed calm. How are you able to play at that highest level but yet keep your head about you all the time?
You just got to stay level-headed, really. You can't get too high. You can't get too low. You have a huge dunk. Obviously, I sometimes let out some emotion, but not too much. And then sometimes you miss layups. You just got to stay composed. Just stay locked into the game. I know he didn't mean anything malicious by it. I could tell by the way he kind of, when I fell, he was still holding me to make sure I didn't fall very hard. So it was just a basketball play. And obviously, it happens. It is what it is, I guess. I'm not mad at it. So,
Trace, can you talk real quick about the role that Anthony played, especially defensively down the stretch tonight? I mean, he and Rob are out there a lot, in the final minutes of the game, and they both of them came up with huge steals. He played 16 minutes, didn't score a point, but it didn't matter. His defense was great.
Anthony, huge role on our team. I think he's starting to carve out that role and knows what he needs to do, and that's be a spot-up shooter and play hard on defense, and he's doing that, and he's just going to keep continuing to grow and get better because we need him on the floor, honestly. And he's one of our best defenders on the team, and you saw it today. He had a huge key stop on that dig. So his props to him, his confidence is going to keep growing. He's just going to keep getting better.